Now for the so-called City Beautiful and home to the Madden Studios, this is EA Sports coverage of the National Football League from Orlando, Florida. Today we've got a Week 6 matchup for you here, as it'll be the Tampa Bay Buccaneers taking on the Dreadnoughts of Orlando. Set to go now in Week 6 of the NFL season, and we are underway on EA Sports. And this will go as a touchback, and they will begin things at the 25. Across the 30 to the 31.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
They'll come up now, second and four from the 31. He'll drop to throw. Oh, his first throw of the game. Going to be intercepted. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race.
Man, I wonder if someone's down there checking on the head coach right now, because he might be in a little bit of shock after what just transpired. Instead of a lengthy opening drive to deal with, his guy stepped up and stole that drive away. Momentum on their side now. How will they attack on offense?
Nothing doing there. They're going to wind up holding him at the two. No gain there, and it's going to set up second and goal. So stuck from the two, now what?
You know me pretty well. What do you think I want here?
Play action?
Definitely. Let him get outside and create. And if he has to run it, he has a little bit more space.
Shot, 17. Cut, cut.
They'll try again. But he will lose yardage here. Back to the four-yard line. The tally there, minus 2 yards, brings up third down.
This has not been a fun sequence for him at all. First and goal, no gain. Second and goal, he ends up losing yardage. He may be trying to talk him into getting the ball a third time, but then it's going to be difficult for him to win that battle.
And put it on the board. It's 6, a touchdown. A great play there. His fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Dreadnoughts take the early turnover and convert it into an opening touchdown. Extra point right down the middle. And that makes the score 7-0. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And the interception on that opening drive winds up leading to the touchdown, so now it's kind of time to start over.
Yeah, it certainly is, and his first throw of the game.
And now off to the races, down the right side. And he's going to get this down inside the 40 before he's finally ridden out of bounds. A big play that time for Tampa Bay. 44 yards. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. They go right back to him for 20 and a first. They'll set up to throw. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Yes, sir. How about an attaboy there on first down? Got his hand in and knocked it away.
Set. second and 10. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Got a man and he hits him in stride. Touchdown! From 17 yards out. And the Buccaneers are within an extra point of tying up this ball game. Chase McLaughlin on for the extra point. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. Yeah, they dipped a game below 500 following the loss last week. And you get the sense that maybe this team's at a little bit of a crossroads here.
Yeah, I think that's a really good way to put it, because what's that old malaprop? If you come to a fork in the road, take it. Because this crew, they're losing ground fast. They've got to start winning some ball games. And the good teams, they're starting to separate themselves, and these guys are being left behind.
Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34.
Drill, 52. Ready?
They'll keep it on the ground. Archer will get three as the drive continues. It's a first down. These two teams met up earlier in the year back in week 4. And it was the visitors getting the win there. So they'll be looking for the sweep back here at home. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Off the play fake, Young. Eluding the pressure right. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down. You look at this defense for Tampa Bay. They're going to need to be strong against the run in this one.
And this group talks all the time about wanting to be better, getting stronger against the run. And to me, it all starts up front. You've got to win the line of scrimmage in order to play against the run very well.
Young throwing complete there to Mingo. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. His first catch of the game, good for 11 and a first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here.
Ready.
And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Now this one complete downfield on the left side. Now he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. Young quickly to the flat. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. Zero hesitation that time. That was get ball, throw ball.
Yeah, turn into a smoke route. If you see the coverage off the receiver, doesn't matter whether you call it a run or not. Just take the ball, get it out to him.
Okay, ready? Needle blue.
First and 10, Young. And too much juice. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete.
So it looks like they still have some fight in them on this series, because it seemed like things were headed for the red zone. But if this defense gets two more stops, they can keep them out of that area.
Young's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. Up the middle they go. Archer. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on that one as it brings up a third and 10.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
It's been a pretty long drive. This will be play number 9. And they need 10 yards out of it on third.
Blaster, stick. Fury, yellow. Hut, hut.
Young to throw it. Oh, it's intercepted. A drive killer there. Picked off by Martin Emerson. And the Bucs are going to get the football here as he gets this up past the 20-yard line. So problems with errant passing continuing. Remember, he threw two picks in the loss last week and now another here in this first quarter.
And sometimes, partner, this is the result of a quarterback who's simply trying to do too much. Feels like he's trying to make up for what he did last week. And he can't do it all on one throw.
The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out. Looking to repeat that in Charles' defense. They were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways because you know they're both motivated. They both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
And not much doing there. Maybe a yard up to the 23. So you look at this defense. There are 32 teams in the NFL, and they're just better than 50% of them at defending the pass, number 16 in the league.
So I'm prepping for this game. I kept asking myself the question, what's keeping this group from being top 10 in the league against the pass?
And?
Too many mistakes, especially little mistakes. And those add up into big mistakes add up into points against you.
And they work this well upfield across the 45. Excellent play there on third down. Give them 25 yards. These two teams all tied after one.
With the score tied 7-7.
Second quarter now, and it's Buccaneer football as they've got it with a first and 10. To throw. He'll get that out to the flat to White, and he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. The result, only 4 yards there on the play, and it'll be second down. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw, and his throw is incomplete. Not sure what happened out there, but it looked like the timing was a little off on that throw.
Well, you know I'm a defender, so what am I going to say?
Great defense.
Darn right. They did something to disrupt that timing.
Back to throw again. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Sometimes the game is pretty simple. Put a few extra defensive backs on the field, give them nowhere to throw the football, force the incompletion, and get off the field on third down.
And the win last week punted 4 times as this one's away. And this is going to hit the goal line and continue on into the end zone for a touchback.
Let's go now.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive. In particular, if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, and some guys, you know they're going to want to try to get a big play right away and take control of that. Others, they're going to look to hit a couple shorter passes and get a little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, that goal's not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you got to watch them a little bit because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit in order to try and get to the ball even faster.
A gain of 3, second down.
They went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Yeah, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, maybe he was a little tired. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a second back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
Steel, Black. Ready.
Young now. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs 30. A solid gain of 15 yards and the sticks move.
Here we go.
2 minutes gone by, second quarter. It's Young on first down. to the sideline, and that is a heck of a catch as he was able to get both feet in. A good pickup there, 26 yards. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the four. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal.
All of a sudden, those lanes that were there earlier in the drive dry up near the goal line. That's a good job defensively to diagnose the run and stop it for a very short pickup.
The second down attempt there knocked down as it leaves the quarterback's hand, and it's incomplete.
I'm really liking what I'm seeing from this defense because their coverage has been playing at a shutdown level so far. Even backed up late, they're forcing incompletions and fighting to keep them out of the end zone as the first half winds down.
Ready.
A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. From the gun, they'll try to run it. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to bring up a fourth and goal. Well, let's see what they do. They're knocking on the door here in the second quarter.
And you know what you look at on your play sheet? Your 2-point conversion plays. Because you've drawn up a number of them in today's football. You don't just have one or two for the game. You have more like 6 or 7. Which one do you like here? Because that's essentially what you're going for right now. That spot of the field, call one of those and go get 6.
Frank Reich here on fourth down is ready to try for 3. And his kick is indeed good. So a long drive gets him down inside the 5, but ultimately they settle for just the field goal.
And I have to think that if maybe they were a yard closer, that would have made their decision tougher, and I think they likely would have gone for it. But in this situation, they just decided to take the 3, and I think it was a smart move.
And a pretty slick return there. Almost got it to the 45. Officially, they'll call him down at the 44.
At some point, we're going to get it through our heads. Special teams, special teams, special teams. The spark that often wins games.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. As we eke closer and closer to intermission, Charles, remember last time out they punted. They would love to get points here, especially if this is going to be their final possession of the first half.
Yeah, and this is what close games feel like because the pressure is on both sides, but sometimes the pressure is a little bit higher on the team with the slight edge because they're trying to hold on to that, trying to increase it. Let's see how this one continues.
Second and 9 from the 44. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And this one is incomplete.
Zone coverage there, and they were playing deep. That makes it obviously a little bit harder to run by guys. And that time, there was not much of a window to get the ball in there, and it winds up incomplete.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he is going to have the Buccaneers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Here we go. Savvy Lion.
First down, here's White. To about the 26 here. Clock running, the Bucs try to go quickly and get set. Here's a 2nd and 7. He finds his man complete. It's Shelton. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down. They run straight ahead here with White. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal.
That was good, tough running right up the middle. And if the defense can't penetrate and make him slow his pace or change direction, that's often the end result.
And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this first half. second and six. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
You know, he's been very good about checking my math. Am I correct? That's the first time that it's been incomplete when they've thrown it to him?
Yes, he had caught every other ball coming his way.
So they feel like they've got something really good going there, and they're going to continue to go there until the defense makes an adjustment and takes it away.
Well, they finally made an adjustment there. We'll see if they can build on that stop. They'll look to throw on third and goal. And in for the Buccaneers touchdown from 6 yards away. And the Bucs will take the lead here in the final minute of the first half. The extra point by McLaughlin is up and good. And the lead is now 14-10. Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25.
Here we go, here we go.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And with him trailing, there is still enough time to try to string a few plays together, maybe get into field goal range. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime.
Here we go.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a 2nd and 5. Young. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously, one that should have been caught. They've got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
They come up now 3rd and 5 following the incomplete pass. Now here's Young. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. A strong pickup of 11 keeps their drive alive.
And I like the idea here. Get the ball in his hands, even if it's in the passing game. 3 catches a week ago, and he does a nice job here to pick up yardage.
The play fake. Now Young. That's complete to McBride. So apparently some grabbing of the jersey there on the O-line.
Yeah, just looking the interior, and that's where the penalty occurred.
They're backed up here with a 1st and 20 now after the holding penalty. Out of the gun, it's Young. That's over the middle and caught by Mingo. Now a timeout. 7 seconds left in the first half.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Going to throw right side here, complete. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. And now we'll get a late timeout as it comes in the waning moments of quarter number 2. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get 3 before halftime. And his kick is good. He got every bit of that one as it's good from 56 yards out. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
Well,
Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. A one-point game through two quarters as we get rolling here in this second half. And we will not have a run back here as the second half starts with a touchback. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. Well, Charles, we saw a pretty entertaining first half, close ball game. Remember there toward the end of the second quarter, the opposition scored to take the lead. Now we'll see if these guys can get a score of their own to regain that lead.
Yeah, they want to have that type of a response, don't they? Because they want to find a way to take control of this ball game one more time. Gauntlet's been thrown down. They want to see if they're ready to answer it.
Second down, Young. He completes this one to Mingo. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Two catches in the first half. Now he's got a third here, and it's good for a first. Now a handoff up the middle. Archer, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up.
They suspected that it was a power play up the middle coming at them, and boy, were they right. That defense got downhill in a hurry and limited them to just a couple on first down.
Come on,
set. From the 43, here's a second and eight.
Claude Ray. Ready?
Here's Young from the shotgun. By rifles one, that's going to be intercepted. It's Devin White, the linebacker. And it's a pick six. He brings it back to the house for a Buccaneer TD. McLaughlin for the extra point. And with that, the lead is up to eight. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. Well, from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line.
Ready,
the offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. Now remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick six, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go-around.
And sometimes, partner, I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick six and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines dwelling for it for very long. You're not hearing everyone say, hey, you'll get it next time. Hey, don't worry about it. All that stuff just goes right out the window. You're right back out on the field with a chance to atone.
78 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
Ready.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Young working out of the gun. Finding his target, it's Trey McBride. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And it'll bring up a second and short.
Got it.
Up the middle they go. Archer. And a good run here as he'll rumble all the way down to the 40-yard line. A gain of 13. It's a first down. He finds his way into the secondary again on this drive. They might want to try getting him down a little closer to the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, what do they call that third level run? First level being the D-line and linebacker second level in the secondary, the third. When you block it up well and you make the secondary do all the tackling, that will wear on a defense.
And a great job there to read that one defensively. They strung him out, would not allow him to cut up field. This defense not fooled one bit on that touch pass.
And this has become one of those kind of in vogue plays, you know, kind of like the shuffle pass was a few years ago. This one never got off the ground, but you understand why a lot of teams are running it. These wide receivers, a lot of them, they've run like running backs with the ball in their hands.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he led him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground incomplete.
Here we go.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Now Young. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. The 12 yards that time and picking up the first.
Okay. Certainly had success throughout this contest, getting him the ball in the passing game, and there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it, and no adjustment has been made to take it away.
His throw incomplete.
Well, a momentary speed bump there with that throw, partner. The defense had other ideas, and they're trying to mount a small stand before this drive reaches the end zone.
Ready up.
Young's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10.
Trouble, 38. Hut, hut.
Now a give, right side, Archer. And he will take this one in for a touchdown. A great effort there. His fifth rushing touchdown now on the year. And the Dreadnoughts have come back to make it a two-point game.
You get in a second and long situation down here in the red zone, I'd say most defensive coaches would think pass, let's bring some pressure. So this is kind of a tendency breaker here to hit him with something on the ground, and he'll take it all the way into the end zone.
And no, it falls incomplete. So the two-point conversion, no good. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. Now they've got the lead here getting late into the third quarter. And the passing game for them, it's been terrific. We've seen that, but the rushing game, almost non-existent.
And with the lead and trying to finish this game off, they need the running game to come back to life. They need to get sparked that way. Take some time off the clock and keep the ball away from their opponents.
Calling a gain of 3 on the play, and it's second down. They will run with White out of the shotgun. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of 2. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
And they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
He's going to get that to his running back out of the backfield. And he is going to have a box first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
He sets to fire deep, and that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in.
Oh, that's some good closing speed there defensively because that looked open for a minute. But that's great work with the ball in the air. Never gave up, converged on his man, and broke the play up.
He's got a man complete, and he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. 33 yards that time. And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Now a give up the middle. This is White. And he'll follow his blockers there all the way down to the 23-yard line. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
Well, it is our business to analyze what we saw out there. And on that play, I saw a defense staying in base, not taking a chance, not blitzing in a situation where they absolutely need the football back. That's either a case of overthinking it or not thinking it through.
If you do blitz, do you have to be careful about where you're coming from, or are you just coming from all angles?
You have to be careful about where you're coming from, obviously. But at this stage, you have to take a few chances as well.
Here's second and 10. They're going to look to throw. Throwing right, and that's complete. They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and three.
And we've seen him have success earlier on with the ball in his hands because he is a get-it-in-space and make-a-play kind of a receiver. But that time, they closed on him quickly and held him to a short game.
Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete. So decision time now, because a field goal keeps it a one-score game. What are you thinking?
Well, I'm looking at the down and distance, and that's where the issue comes in. It's not short enough that it's a no-brainer and you go for it. You have to analyze this one. To me, you take the field goal, take the points. I don't think you want to risk coming away with nothing.
And here's a big one now. Try to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. He's got his running back out of the backfield. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. How about them biting off 15 yards there on the fourth down attempt and keeping the drive alive? So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. They'll look to throw again. Toward the pylon, but it's incomplete.
And there, once he's outside of the pocket and doesn't see anything, very smart play to just throw it away. That was only first down. He's got a few more shots maybe. He can take in the end zone.
So an incomplete pass a moment ago, and that leads to second and goal. Again, he'll drop to throw. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. A great play there. With his second touchdown of the game, fourth of the year. And the Bucs will add to their fourth quarter lead. Extra point by McLaughlin is up and good. And that makes this a 9-point game. Following the touchdown, here's McLaughlin to kick off. Fair catch going to be taken, and this will be moved out to the 25. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And the script really is flipped for them. The momentum on the other sideline, and now they have to try and battle back from a two-score deficit. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. A nice little screen. They get six on first down.
And a really nice play call there to start the drive, especially if you're a team that has a little bit of a reputation for throwing it downfield. You come out, and you think maybe you can catch them off guard a little bit, and they did. Little screen pass, backdoored them, and that time worked well for a solid gain.
Ready? On second down, Young. And that'll be incomplete.
His back has been a dependable safety valve all game, so he went back to him when his first read was covered. Just unable to connect, so the play results in no gain.
Ready, set. And this offense on third down today, they've converted three out of five thus far. This is third and four. Young will set to throw. He's got his target. That's complete. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage.
Let's go now. Black Ultra.
That's good.
Ready?
Young to throw it. Throwing left side. It's complete. And he will go out right near the 35-yard line. A good pick up there, 26 yards.
Well, every drive from here out is definitely crucial and critical. They know that they need to get at least three here to get it back to a one-score game. But I can't imagine that in their huddle that they're thinking at all about getting a field goal. They want to get into the end zone and then try and get the ball back again.
And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds. 136 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here. got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. And he'll head out of bounds inside the 10, marking down at the 9. 11 more on that one and another first down.
Just picking up yardage in bunches here these last few plays. They have moved right down the field, and just like that, they're going to be set up with a first and goal.
Clock, 10.
Young to throw it. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6.
Young,
he's going to change it up. From the gun, he'll hand this off. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. That's a big loss of 3, and it brings up third down. Young now. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. And the Buccaneers are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. They start the drive with White. They find some open field here, and they're able to get this one across the 35. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive. First down. Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
From the 38 now, here comes second and 8.
Go, Reed. Go.
They stay on the ground with White. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 10 yards there and a Buccaneer first down. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory.
Reload, reload.
5 points of contact necessary at this stage as they'll run on first down. He'll get it up near midfield to the 49 before being taken down. This, in all probability, another run here on second and 8. They'll go up the middle with White. And a good run here as he'll rumble all the way down to the 40-yard line. It's a gain of 11, and the Bucs have a first down.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. On second down, they'll run with White. Officially nothing on that one, no gain, so they're left with still 10 to go on third down. Nice job there defensively to clamp down, because really, they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
So that one, a hold right guard.
And you understand why offensive and defensive linemen probably go to martial arts schools and work on their hands so often, because that could be the make or break difference on a play. This time he had to grab a jersey in order to make the play happen. Got caught for the penalty.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. Here comes the Buccaneers punter now. He'll boot it away from about his 35. His first punt, 48 yards. This one looks equally as good. And that is very well done there, as this will be marked out of bounds at the 5-yard line.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb.
I think they're ahead of schedule now after that run. They might be bold with this second down call after that type of a game.
On the double.
Here's second down and 3.
Hut, hut.
Throw left side, pulled in by Mingo. Oh, that's just that's not fair, and now room to run. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. So time has run out on what will be a Tampa Bay victory. And they were spurred on by a strong performance in that fourth quarter as they held their opponents off the scoreboard.
Everyone wants to pitch a shutout for the entire game, but when you throw one in the fourth quarter, that tells everyone that you're getting stronger and dominance is starting to take over, right? The way that you close, the way that you finish, that gets preached to you from the time you're playing Little League football all the way up through. And they closed them out with a big-time performance down the stretch.